It's those like you who consciously acknowledge the relationship between where you currently stand and how you currently feel in your physical bodies, and what your astral body or your spiritual body or your soul body or your source body or your inner being body of energy is. It's the relationship between you and that which you've expanded to, which includes us. It's that relationship that equals every emotion that you feel. So when you decide, as you all did, that you're going to carve out a slice of your important lives and center yourselves inside a conversation with the express intent of joining and meshing with and blending with and understanding, merging with, becoming, allowing the human consciousness that you've come to know as you with the fullness of who you really are. When you make a decision like that, you have decided to contribute to humanity in the most effective way. Because you say, I will merge with the whole of that which I am, a little bit here and a little bit here, but it is my quest. And in doing so, I will learn and I will study and I will practice and I will become, I will be a consistent light into this world. I will tune to the energy of all that I have become, and I will so consistently flow it that anyone who gets a whiff of me will benefit, whether they speak, whether they understand or not. And for your willingness to do all of that, we stand in complete love and appreciation for that willingness, because it required an effort and a focus and a sticking with a new idea, even a unpopular new idea. It required doing something that the other chickens aren't doing. It required perceiving outside the box. It required a paradigm shift. It required a letting go of physical reality and achieving of non-physical reality. It required merging with the God that is really you, but it required letting go of the human that is you in profound and unpopular ways. So as we observe you, and as we feel you, and as we salivate over you, and as we find the deliciousness of you, as we focus upon who you are and what you've done and what you know and how far you've come and why you've done it and how you will continue to do it and what it means to you and how you'll find the feeling place of it and the effort that you will make. Our appreciation of you is not just for what you've accomplished in getting here and in playing with us in these hours that we've been together. Our appreciation that we are expressing to you now from our present tense is about what you are yet to do in your physical body, for which we are now all in complete celebration about. The things that you seek, the successes that are still future tense for you, have already been accomplished, and we are savoring them now. And our powerful desire for you is that you will come frequently to your vortex of creation, where you will ABC yourself through your alphabet into emotional reasoning, where you will feel the fullness of the celebration that we all have as a result of the work that you have and are continuing to do. There have never been humans with greater intensity than those who have gathered here, really. And there have never been those who have been more willing to listen to the sameness of the message that we continue to offer forward, determined to eke out one more little piece of understanding that just puts the world in a little bit of a righter place. We applaud you for your patience, and we encourage you to come to the vortex where you never need it. And we express to you appreciation of all that you are, and eagerness that you feel love for yourselves in the way that we do right now. So we wish to express to you the brilliance of who you are. You are physically focused beings who are source energy instead of physically focused beings. You are the leading edge of the universe, and in your physical bodies, you are beacons who will lead millions of others who want what you have but don't know what you know. You have no assignment to teach them. It is through the clarity of your example that it will happen. And because of your participation in these hours that we've been together, you have gathered around you in a rather consistent and intense fashion a cadre of non-physical energies. You can call them fairies of the universe or angels, you can call them anything you want, who have always known you, but whom you have not always known. But your feeling for them and your finding of them will be more vivid to you. And that feeling of standing out there on the leading edge, sort of lonely because others don't get you, is fast fading as your new association with who you really are has powerfully taken its place. It will no longer be necessary for others to get you in order for you to stand and know who you are. In fact, you're going to find it a very common thing that flows forth from you when others say, "I don't really understand what you mean," for you to say, "It doesn't matter." You are going to find yourself teaching without anyone asking for a classroom. You're going to find yourself understanding without anyone really verbalizing a problem. You're going to find yourself vibrationally speaking, knowing from inside your vortex what it feels like to be tuned in to infinite intelligence. Solutions are going to flow forth to you more emphatically than you've ever experienced before, and you're going to find yourself often standing as a very clear-minded being amidst others who are standing in a place of somewhat confusion. And you're not going to feel uncomfortable in your leadership. As you hear people complaining, you won't take their complaints to heart at all, but you're going to feel a solution forming within you and words to back up the solution, and you're going to find yourself telling people what you know on a more consistent basis without offending them, because you're not going to be considering their point of view and your point of view at the same time. You're going to be speaking profoundly from your point of view. In other words, one who's connected to this source energy, one who's flowing with the stream from inside the vortex, is more powerful and more influential than millions who are not. And in giving all of this to you, it is our powerful desire that you understand that this is not an assignment that we are assigning to you. It is the fulfilling of the intention that you set forth and are acknowledging to you that you have accomplished what you have set forth to accomplish. You are creators who have come into this environment for the details that it evokes from you. But you are God force who insists upon alignment with the energy of your source. And it is our knowing that as you move forward from this day, never again will you feel negative emotion without blessing the importance of it, because in the negative emotion is the indication that you are setting forth for this universe expansion. And instead of feeling a continuing of negative emotion, you're going to flip, you're going to take the bounce, you're going to feel the solution that your problem has pointed, and you're going to feel it fast. You're going to feel how we feel more often as you explore the contrast of your time-space reality. what has happened in this time that we've been together. And even though we can speak it and you cannot, and we can feel it, and maybe you are getting some of it, over the days that follow, you are going to feel the profound meaning of what we are offering here. Because you have managed to activate an inside the vortex vibration with enough consistency and frequency that your point of attraction has shifted dramatically. And the lives around you, which you call physical manifestational, and we call them manifestational indicators of vibration, are going to show it. So hold on to your hats and get ready to feel the celebration many times in every day of your newfound freedom in your newfound absence of resistance. There could not be greater love or appreciation focused at you than now. There could not be more recognition of the worthiness of that which is you than that which we feel here and now. And there could not be more eager anticipation for the manifestation that by law must follow as a result of what you have accomplished vibrationally as a result of this gathering. And with all of that, we say to you, you have done the work and we have received the benefit, which is exactly the way you so lovingly set it all up when you decided to come forth. And we want you to feel the appreciation of that which you call God and that which we call all that is, for the expansion of the universe that is as a result of the beingness that is you. It is time for you to love you as we do and reap the benefit of you as we do. There is great love here for you. And we will remain and expect as much of you eternally in the vortex.